श्रीमद्वेङ्कटनाथार्यं वन्दे वेदान्तदेशिकं लक्ष्मीनाथसमारम्भां नाथयां न मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां यो नित्यमच्युतपदाम्बुजयुग्मरुक्मव्यामोहतस्तदितराणि तृणाय मेने अस्मद्गुरोर्भगवतोऽस्य दयैकसिन्धोः रामानुजस्य चरणौ शरणं प्रपद्ये।
India, the spiritual capital of the world. Within this pious land is Dravida Desh, South India, the land of magnificent temples, the birthplace of empowered acharyas, and the very cradle of Vaishnavism. Era 1000 AD. A wave of devotion to Lord Narayan was spreading across the land, overcoming stiff opposition by foreign invaders, rampant impersonalism, and rising atheism. Spearheading this devotional revolution was a philosopher, saint, and devotee, the great Ramanujacharya. The flame of his life's mission was ignited through his faithful and mystical connection with the great Yamunacharya.
Why such crowds?
Nambi! What can I say? The earth is now bereft of its most valuable jewel.
Just look. Yamunacharya's face is still serene and untouched by the shadow of death.
Yes. The brilliant sun of the Sri Sampradaya has set and plunged the world into dense darkness. The great Yamunacharya has returned to the abode of the Lord.
Who will inherit the mission of compassion now?
Alavandar!
Mahapurna! Mahapurna!
Alavandar!
Ramanuja!
Oh, Narayana!
Seekar, seekar, jalo kondo vanga seekaram!
Ramanuja!
Someone Sikram. Please hold Ramanuja!
Indripa! Indri...
Ramanuja, I came to Kanjipuram on the request of Yamunacharya only to invite you to come to Rangakshetra and give your association to us. My master wished to see you, Ramanuja, but now just see.
Look at Ramanuja.
It seems that he has transcended the barrier of death and is fully in the presence of Yamunacharya.
I can hardly believe that such an exalted devotee was even aware of my existence, let alone being desirous of my association. If only he could have cast his merciful glance upon me at least once when alive, I would have become free from all material bondage. I see that three fingers of Sri Yamunacharya's right hand are folded and clenched tight. Were they always like this during his lifetime?
No, his fingers would always remain straight.
I don't think any of us can guess why they are like this now.
You
Remaining fixed in devotion to Lord Vishnu, I shall free the people from all illusion by spreading the glories of the Lord throughout the land.
Swami, did you see? One finger has opened.
To establish that there is no truth beyond Lord Vishnu, I shall write the Sri Bhashya, commentary on the Vedant Sutra, which will soundly defeat all the atheistic philosophies.
Unbelievable! Second finger has also opened.
In order to show respect to the great sage Parashar, the author of Vishnu Puran, I shall name one learned Vaishnava after him.
This great Vaishnava understands our Guru's heart.
Having understood the three unfulfilled desires of Yamunacharya's heart, the Lord has mercifully revealed that although the sun has set, the moon of Ramanuja has risen in the horizon of Sri Vaishnavism.
At this time, Ramanuja was still a householder. However, in order to fulfill these promises, the all-knowing Lord orchestrated his life in such a way that he was compelled to renounce his family ties. One day, Mahabhagwat Sripad Kanchipurna, the Lord's confidential associate who regularly conversed with Lord Vardaraj,
"My dear Vardaraj, how can I recount my infinitely good fortune of fanning your holy form every day?"
Kanchipuram, your simple, pure-hearted service is always most pleasing to my heart.
My dear Lord, your dear devotee Ramanuj is accepting the sannyas order of life today. May I request you to kindly inspire an appropriate sannyas name for him?
Ramanuja is my very special devotee. You should name him Yatiraj, the king among renunciants. My dear Lord, from this day, I'm yours in every way. Please accept me.
Yatiraj had several spiritual masters, and with the passing of years, he felt increasing joy in learning from them. One such great personality was Sripad Ghostipurna.
Mahatma Ghostipurna?
I am Ramanuja, an insignificant disciple of Sripad Mahapurna. On his order, I have come to Tirukottiyur to beg you to kindly impart to me the secret Vedic mantra.
You may come here some other day and we will consider your request.
Yatiraj walked from Sri Rangam to Tirukottiyur 18 times, each time returning with a dejected heart.
Gurudev, there must be some great impurity in my heart that is preventing you from bestowing your mercy upon me.
My dear Ramanuj, I am deeply impressed by your sincerity and devotion. And now, I can see that you are worthy to receive the secret Vedic mantra. But please listen carefully. Only Lord Vishnu is aware of the glories of this mantra. And whoever chants it is certain to go back to Vaikuntha at the time of death. Because this mantra is so pure and sacred, it must not be touched by lips of anyone who has any material desires. Therefore, my firm instruction to you is that you must not disclose this mantra to any other person.
Life is successful, for I have become blessed by receiving the rarest of treasures. My heart feels deep pain when I see the sufferings of all living beings in this world. If only I could save them. Yes, yes, today I will deliver them. My dear friends, all of you are more dear to me than my very life. Therefore, I have a strong desire to deliver you all from the torments of sufferings of this mortal world. Now, all of you please rise and accept this priceless jewel. Rise, rise and repeat after me. Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo
Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Now that all of you have sincerely chanted this mantra, please know with faith that you'll surely see the doors of Vaikuntha open at the end of this very life.
Ramanujacharya ki.
Gurudrohi, you lowest among the men, get out of my sight! I, Goshtipurna, have committed a great sin today by giving the most precious gem to such an unworthy person like yourself. Surely, you're destined to live in hell for countless lifetimes for having committed such a grievous Guru Apradh.
It was only because I was prepared to suffer in hell that I dared to commit the sin of going against your order. You told me that whoever chants this 8-syllable mantra will reach the very gates of Vaikuntha. And now, so many people are destined to find the shelter of Lord Narayan's lotus feet. For this, if an insignificant person like me has to go to hell, it is of no consequence.
Your words reveal the depth of compassion of your pure heart, my child. I have never known anyone so magnanimous as yourself. There is no doubt that you are the most intimate associate of the Lord. Whereas I am nothing but a common man who could not comprehend the greatness of your heart. From today, you, Ramanuj, are my guru, and I am your disciple.
Although I committed the offense of transgressing your order, I have become eternally fortunate by receiving your embrace, which is desired even by the gods.
You're simply wonderful, Ramanuj. Your compassion will earn you eternal fame.
This incident brought increasing fame and popularity to the holy reputation of Sripad Ramanujacharya, much to the displeasure of the envious. One such crooked character was the high priest of the temple of Lord Ranganath.
So, my dear wife, I hope you have successfully executed the plot we devised together to finish off that Ramanuja.
I had all intention to do as you had planned. I gave him the heavily poisoned food, but I don't know what overcame me. Looking at his pure, saintly demeanor, my heart softened and I told him, if you want to save yourself, then go elsewhere to take your meal. If you take this food, then you will die.
Victory and good fortune were at my doorstep. But you idiotic woman! What can I expect from a woman? But doesn't matter. My fertile brains can devise numerous plans. I have learned one thing in life. Self-preservation is the first law of nature, and hence the end justifies the means. Today, when that Ramanuja, my arch rival, comes to the temple, This bottle will bring him instantly to eternal life. He will not see the rising sun tomorrow.
I don't understand. What is it in me that evokes such hatred in his heart for me?
Hmm.
Oh, Karuna Sindhu, how great is your affection for your devotees. I know there is poison in this Charanamrit, but your mercy is causeless and unlimited.
Oh, Narayana, look what has happened.
What has happened?
Come,
the great Yatiraj has fainted.
It's working.
Has he become unconscious?
After all, the Charanamrit had enough poison to kill 10 men.
Unbelievable. How on earth is this possible? Who is this person? Have I committed a grave offense?
I tried to kill you, to destroy your good reputation. No, no, I have no right to live. Cast me in the flames of fire. Only then will my blazing envy be extinguished.
My dear sir, please do not injure yourself in this way. You are a servant of Lord Ranganath, and he has forgiven you for your sins. Believe me.
Yes. Now I believe with firm faith that you are the real Acharya of Sri Rangam and not me.
After becoming an Acharya at Sri Rangam and having accepted several disciples, Ramanujacharya began traveling extensively in pursuit of his proclaimed promise to Sripad Yamunacharya. One day, while on his way to Sri Shaila,
I can see that all of you are very tired walking all day long. I suggest that we take rest tonight at my disciple Yagnesh's house before we continue our pilgrimage to Sri Shaila.
Yagnesh Gurudev, that wealthy disciple of yours?
Yes.
Really? Gurudev has come?
Yes, and he has expressed his desire to take rest tonight at your place along with all his disciples. So we thought of asking you if this will not be of much inconvenience to you.
Inconvenience? What inconvenience? It would be my great fortune to serve Gurudev. I am so thankful to you. I will at once go and get all the necessary arrangements done. Srinivas, you come with me to the market. Get the coconuts immediately. Let's get all the arrangements done and have a grand welcome for our Gurudev.
Gurudev, your message has been communicated to Yagnesh. He is excitedly preparing for your arrival. That's all right.
But how did he receive you? We are not going to Ignatius' place. One cannot please the master without humble loving service to the disciple. This is a cardinal Vaishnava principle.
It's better we go to my simple disciple Varadacharya's house.
Srimad Narayana Narayana Hari Hari Narayana Narayana Hari Hari
Om Namo Narayanaya.
Oh, Gurudev, please come. All of you, please come inside. It is our great fortune to have you here. All of you, please sit here and be merciful to me by accepting this water.
Narayan.
My husband is still out begging us. Just nearby there is a lake where you may bathe. And in the meantime, I will prepare the offering for Lord Narayana.
Narayana Vatirastu.
How would I serve my Guru Maharaj in this situation? There is not even a single grain here. People always long to serve their Guru. And here I am, who is blessed with this opportunity. But now I have realized my poverty is my misfortune. Oh Lord Venkatesh, what should I do now? There is one way.
Aha! This prasad is very delicious.
Such opulent prasad in a poor man's house?
Gurudeva?
Ah, come, Varadacharya. You have come at the right time.
What else can I ask from Lord Venkatesh than your presence here and a great opportunity for us to serve your lotus feet?
My dear Varadacharya, your wife's hospitality in offering such opulent prasadam to all of us has left us wonderstruck. Both of you are indeed very rich due to the service attitude that you carry in your simple heart, which is full of devotion to Lord Hari.
Lakshmi, from where did you arrange all this?
I am ashamed to tell you, but I have agreed to surrender myself to the wicked desires of the rich businessman next door in exchange of all these foodstuffs and other arrangements. He had always eyed me with impure motives and often tried to seduce me with his wealth. But I never entertained him. However, I could not think of any other way but this, to serve Gurudev and all our God brothers. Please forgive me. Please forgive me.
Today, you have shown the highest degree of chastity. Only a great soul like you can act like this. How fortunate I am to be married to such a virtuous lady like you, who is the embodiment of religious principles.
Lakshmi, your willingness to go to any extent to please your spiritual master is breaking my heart. May Lord Hari bless you with all the happiness in the three worlds and give the shade of his lotus feet to both of you. It is a matter of great pride to have disciples like you. Varadacharya, now that you have promised the merchant, go with Lakshmi to his house and deliver him this prasad.
Gurudev, your causeless mercy is his only hope.
Aha, Lakshmi, you have actually come. You are indeed a woman of words. Come, come. At last, destiny has turned in my favor. My long wait has borne fruit today. Please come and feel comfortable.
I am indeed grateful to you for helping me in my hour of need. I will certainly fulfill your desires. But before that, I request you to eat this special preparation which I have made for you.
Anything from your hands, Lakshmi. How sinful I am! My fate would have been doomed! Only by your great compassion have I been saved, O Mother. Please forgive all my offenses and have mercy upon me.
I'm just an insignificant disciple of the great Ramanujacharya, and the prasad you ate was his remnants.
How glorious must be your spiritual master to have disciples of your caliber. And his remnants have miraculously transformed a degraded debauchee like me. Yes, I want to surrender my life to him. Please take me to him, O Mother.
Although his mission had now taken roots in most of the southern states of India, Ramanuja's heart was still restless and unfulfilled.
Gurudev, you seem to be lost in some deep thought.
Yes, Gurish. I was meditating on my given promise to Shripad Yamunacharya. I had made a solemn vow to him to write an authentic Vaishnav commentary on the Vedanta Sutra.
A Vaishnav commentary on the Vedanta Sutra is fundamental to the authenticity of a bona fide Sampradaya. It would be a monumental contribution to our Sri Sampradaya.
But before setting out on such an ordained task, it is essential for me to study the Bodhayan Vritti, written by the sage Bodhayan. It is such a rare book that I have been unable to locate a single copy of it anywhere in this part of the country. However, I have heard that there is only one copy of it at the Sharda Peeth in Kashmir. Kuresh, I would be happy if you can accompany me in this mission.
Gurudev, assisting you has always been the exclusive pleasure of my life.
Then let's leave immediately for Kashmir.
It has been such a wondrous experience for us here. O great scholar, to be able to be acquainted with you and your disciples.
Of course, very true. We are greatly honored to have met you. Is there anything that we could do for you?
You embarrass me with your praises that I'm sure I do not deserve. But nevertheless, I'm extremely grateful. And as a matter of fact, I do have a request for all of you.
Oh, why not?
I have always wanted to study the Bodhayan Vritti, written by the great sage Bodhayan, the singular copy of which is only found here at the Sharda Peet. May I request all of you noble souls that the Bodhayan Vritti may be delivered to me?
He is a powerful scholar, but with Vaishnav beliefs, if he will study the Bodhayan Vritti, he will surely come out with strong arguments against us. I'm sorry, Acharya, but I just remembered that the book you wanted was with us until recent. But now, the worms have eaten it up and it is completely destroyed.
Oh, Narayana, the loss of this book would mean the loss of my cherished dream. Kuresh, all our labor of these 3 months' arduous journey has been futile.
Gurudev, please do not be despondent. Now, let us take rest for the night and we shall see what tomorrow has in store for us.
It's an honor for a spiritual master to have a faithful disciple like you, Kuresh.
Dasosmi.
Ramanuja, do not be dismayed, my child. Here, take this granth, the Bodhayan Vritti. Immediately leave this place and fulfill your glorious mission.
Kuresh, look Kuresh, the Bodhayan Vritti. Ma Sharda just gave it to me. At last, the Bodhayan Vritti.
The Bodhayan Vritti?
Yes Kuresh, hide this immediately amongst our belongings. Let's bid farewell to the pandits and leave soon.
After some days, the pandits realized that the book was missing, and they immediately doubted Ramanuja and his disciple. Although Ramanuja and Kuresh tirelessly walked through forests to try and reach Srirangam as soon as possible, the pandits catch up with them and they forcefully snatch away the book and return back to Kashmir.
Treasure lost, Kuresh. Valuable treasure lost again.
Do not be unhappy, O Master. By the Lord's grace, every night of our journey, while you were sleeping, I have been studying the Vritti. Now I know the whole book by heart. I suggest we stop here for some time and I can write in the whole Vritti for you.
Adbhut! Adbhut! I have no words to express. How pleased I am with you, Kuresh. You have made me eternally indebted to you. Thank you, Kuresh. Thank you.
Thus was born the illustrious Sri Bhashya, thereby fulfilling one more promise to the great Yamunacharya. This crowning glory earned Yatiraj the title Sri Sampradaya Shiromani.
Now, Gurudev, with this added weapon of the Sri Bhashya Tika, expounding the Vishishta Advaita philosophy, you have become invincible in rooting out the atheistic doctrines of impersonalism and Jainism.
Could possibly refute the powerful arguments of Ramanujacharya, who was none other than Ananta Shesh. His thousand hoods. He simultaneously answered the thousand questions of the Jain sadhus by expounding the infallible philosophy of Vaishnavism, of complete surrender to the personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan. Ramanujacharya spent much of his time at Sri Rangam, a place where holy festivities were a way of life.
What punya we must have performed to be born and live in this holy land of Sri Rangam, the abode of Lord Ranganath.
The Lord has arrived.
It is nothing less than Vaikuntha, Swami. Practically every day we have a festival here.
Look, look at him. Adbhut Sondarya.
Nam Perumal. Look at his graceful gait.
Sahasra Shirsha Purushaha.
Here is such a great festival is going on, and this person is oblivious to what is happening around him. Paityam, paityam. Such a crazy and shameless fellow he is. Everyone is captivated by Nam Peruman, but the only thing on his mind is that girl.
Just see how he is staring at her.
Vittu thalli, polam.
Infatuation, Swami.
Leave it.
Infatuation.
Dashrathi, just look at that man. Bereft of any sense of decent behavior, he is making a fool of himself.
Very funny and surprising indeed.
Go and ask him to come to me.
Excuse me, oh gentleman.
What?
Listen, gentlemen. Over there is Yatiraj, the great devotee of Lord Narayan.
Oh, how can I serve you?
He wishes to speak with you. So please come with me.
Oh my God. Such a great sadhu wants to talk to me?
Yes. Come immediately.
Oh, lotus-eyed one. I will be back in a minute. Please stay here and wait for me.
My dear gentleman, what nectar have you found in that young lady? That giving up all shame and fear of public opinion? You think nothing of making yourself a laughing stock throughout the whole city of Srirangam by acting in such a way?
Oh Mahatma, I have seen so many beautiful sights on this earth, but never have I seen such enchanting and mesmerizing beauty as this girl's eyes. When I see them, I become so much captivated that I just cannot look away.
Is she your wife?
No, she's not married to me. But I am certain that I will never love any other woman as much.
What is your name?
My name is Dhanur Das, and I hail from the town of Nichula Nagar. And that young lady's name is Hemamba.
Then I have a question for you, Dhanur Das.
Yes, sir.
If I can show you a pair of eyes, even more beautiful than those of your beloved, will you give up this lady and love the other?
If it were possible to discover a pair of eyes with more haunting beauty than those of my Hemamba, then surely I would leave her and worship that person instead who possesses them.
Then come with me today evening.
All right. As you desire, Yatiraj.
Behold, Dhanurdas, the fountainhead, the very source of oceanic boundless beauty.
Amazing! By showing me these eyes, Yatiraj, you have opened my eyes into a realm of beauty infinitely beyond any beauty of this mortal world. In an instant, my attraction to this world has faded like the stars at sunrise. By your causeless mercy, you have given this most lusty man pleasures that are sought even by the demigods in heaven. Like an owl at night, I had turned away from the sun and had become infatuated with a glowworm.
Dhanurdas, the flow of the river of your life was going elsewhere. Now, you should take shelter of Lord Ranganath, who is Karuna Sindhu, the ultimate ocean of mercy.
Yes, now that you have opened my eyes, you alone are my master. Please accept me as your most fallen servant and take me in your service, Acharya. Keep me in your service.
Govindam आदिपुरुषम् तमहं भजामि।
Besides Sri Rangam, the Acharya conducted much of his missionary activities from Melakote, earlier known as Yadavadri. There he excavated the long-lost deity of Yadavadripati, Lord Tirunarayan. Thereafter, under the instruction of the Lord, he went to meet the Emperor of Delhi, where another historical event took place.
Oh, so you are the great Ramanujacharya. Your scholarship has earned you great fame all over the country of Hindustan.
I am honored indeed to meet Your Excellency, the Emperor of Delhi.
Mashallah, mashallah. Your pure demeanor is truly impressive. But I am surprised that you have traveled so long to this city. Can I know the reason that calls you here?
Oh, saintly king, thank you for your kind gesture in allowing me to meet you in person. It is indeed my fortune to be standing in front of you. I came here all the way from South India to fulfill a sacred mission of the Lord.
Oh, yes?
Your soldiers raided South India and forcibly carried away many of our worshipable deities.
We have serious religious differences with you Hindus.
That may be, but your soldiers have carried away one very special ancient deity named Rampriya. I wish to take Sri Rampriya back to South India, wherein he can again be worshipped as per our customs of Vaishnav beliefs.
You are our esteemed guest, and it would be my duty to honor your request. But I am not sure which idol you are referring to. However, I can surely ask my men to escort you to the hall where all such possessions are kept.
Thank you for honoring our request. I shall go and find him myself.
So, did you find the one you're looking for?
No, Your Excellency. His beauty can grab my attention in any crowd. No, Sri Rampriya is not to be found here. Is there any other place that we can search for?
No, Ramanuja. You have seen all that we have. But wait, there is one more idol in my possession, which is the most beautiful of all. My daughter, Princess Bibi Lachimar, has kept it in her own private chamber. Come, I will show you.
Oh, my beloved Lord, your presence in my life has met all the royal pleasures which are abundantly available to this Lakshman, simply pale and insignificant. You are the Lord of my heart. I am simply your Dasi. I will soon be back after making a beautiful garland for you with the fragrant roses and lilies growing in the royal garden. Please wait for me.
Rampriya! Rampriya!
It seems that he is the one you are looking for.
Yes, sir. He is the one. He is Rampriya. My life and soul. The same Rampriya who was worshipped by Lord Brahma. In fact, he became famous as Rampriya because he was very dear to the heart of Lord Ram, who also worshipped him. I found him, the worshipable deity of Lord Krishna and Balram. So, Your Excellency, can I take him with your kind permission?
Yes, but you have just seen how fond my daughter is of this idol. So you can take it, if it comes to you.
O Emperor, now please give me permission to leave. I depart with a grateful heart.
For many more years, Shripad Ramanujacharya continued his mission on earth, thereby establishing 74 centers of Sri Vaishnavism, initiating 700 sannyasis, 12,000 brahmacharis, and thousands of householders, including kings and wealthy landowners. Towards the culmination of his illustrious life in this mortal world of 120 years, his disciples had begun to feel the pangs of his imminent separation. At that time, something special happened.
It's impossible for us to bear the pain of separation, which must surely overwhelm us if you leave us now.
Our request is that we never be deprived of the sight of your transcendental form, Yatiraj.
So be it.
Within 3 days, a deity of Sri Ramanujacharya was carved.
This is my second self. When I have cast off this body, you may worship this form instead of me.
Thus, having accomplished his mission on earth, Shripad Ramanujacharya now decided to return to the abode of his Lord, the Lord of Vaikuntha.
ಮಧುದಾಶ ಪಡೆ ಎಂಬೆರುಮಾನಾರರುಗೋ ಕಾಂಚೀಪುರ ಭರದರಾಜು ಗಾಚಿನ ವಾಡಡುಗೋ ರಂಗನಾಥುಡಾಶ ಪಡೆ ಎಂಬೆರುಮಾನಾರರುಗೋ ಕಾಂಚೀಪುರ ಭರದರಾಜು ಗಾಚಿನ ವಾಡಡುಗೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶು ಶಂಕು ಚಕ್ರಂಬುಲ ದಾಟಡುಗೋ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥುನಿ ಗುರುಬಗು ರಾಮಾನುಜುಲರುಗೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶು ಶಂಕು ಚಕ್ರಂಬುಲ ದಾಟಡುಗೋ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥುನಿ ಗುರುಬಗು ರಾಮಾನುಜುಲರುಗೋ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ಶಂಖಾರಾವಪು ವಿಷ್ಣು ತೇಜ ಮದಿಗೋ ಭರತಾವನಿ ಭಾವಲಹರಿ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಧ್ವಜ ಮದಿಗೋ ಚರಗನಿ ಚಿರು ನವ್ವುಲ ಶ್ರೀ ಭಾಷ್ಯಕಾರುಡಡುಗೋ
RG Media YouTube channel. Like, share, subscribe.